Come here. Come on.
What are you afraid of? Come on. You scared?
Don't you want to come up here? Come here. Come here. Come here.
What are you afraid of? Come here. Come here.
Okay. Oh, come on. Come on.
Come on. Come on, you damn lapdog. Come on.
Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on.
Ah, sorry. I didn't want to drop you.
Sorry for the discomfort.
Are you okay? I didn't mean to hurt you. Stink. You're stanky, Jack Russell Terrier. Stanky. I do, and I don't. What can look better in this character?
Oh, what's up, Indigenous? How are you? Or X, sorry.
This is just a color study for panels for pages of a comic I'm putting out for free. I'm just trying to figure out where I want to put the blacks because I'm stupid. So I really had no directions of this redraw to exactly put the blacks. So I'm just trying to study everything. If it were to be color, but since you're here, I got something to show you. I was working on it a little bit yesterday, but I wasn't sure we could talk about it tomorrow. Tomorrow, Saturday. Dummy. This is the drawing you sent me, and I was just trying to get the drafting. It's not, of course, obviously, it's not done yet, but trying to work on your drawing and make it look like you from what you gave me. I just wasn't familiar with what exactly these were, so of course I wasn't completely correct with them at first. At first I thought it was supposed to be some type of dog hybrid. There we go. I didn't want to keep it up because it was your characters and your drawing. But I can continue working on it if you'd like. On this stream. Okay, they're demons. Obviously human feet. I mean, human based bodies. Alright. Well, down here, just out of curiosity, is that supposed to be, like, talents? Yes, that's the image I could get. Ah, okay. I was...
Okay.
The one on the right with the horns, are they more, goat-like, Okay, ram-like or goat-like? I'm sorry. Goat-like or ram-like? Okay, and I put a bun her right here. I noticed she's not really supposed to have a bun. Okay. Where am I? Sorry. Trying to get an image search of a ram. Come on, bro. There we go. It's like every couple years, dog-like legs.
Okay.
I type in ram and the first thing I get is the truck. Yeah. I'm sorry, I gotta work on that one. When I was looking at the drawing, I was looking at it off my phone, so my eyes were kind of scrunched up, and I need to lower this guy a little bit because I was trying to. I couldn't get his muscle mass right. Yeah, I gotta take this whole part out. Sorry, I have to fling stuff all over the place by accident. Yeah, I screwed up this part. That's why it all looked fucked up. You're right. Damn, dude. Okay, so let's see. Let's do this. Yeah, I kind of screwed up on the demon when I first drew it anyway, so I gotta lower him anyways. This guy's gotta be a little lower from what your drawing is. I mean, it's got to be, it's higher from what you're drawing is. It needs to be lower. That's why the arm looks screwed up, because I was trying to make the arm rest exactly in the same place as resting like you're drawing, and that's why your arm looks big. Now it's night. Now, also the other thing is, these are your characters, and I'm trying to just trying to copy your intentions, not mine. I guess that's a proper word to say it. So, yeah, this demon's got to be a little bit lower. So, say, is this a, yeah, more in the armpit, like, right here. You got kind of a, is he leaning over? Or is it a bird's eye view? Okay, that's the armpit right there. So, Okay. Kind of like a smaller King Kong and Jane. I mean, a smaller King Kong to Jane, like a scale. Yes. Yes. I do cylinders and circles all the time. Problem is, if I start using cylinders and other references besides besides that, my mindset will go into drawing my own route. Drawing things the way I want to, but for the way I studied situations like this, because you know, in the beginning when I first went to art school, and you know, it's fair enough, fair argument, they're like copying comic books, your favorite comic books and your comic book artists and their pages only make you a copier. You're not drawing any of your own stuff, which is true. Basically, if I draw Jim Lee's pages, I'm just copying Jim Lee's pages, which could be great. But that's problem in my mindset. I start breaking these completely down from what you want. It wouldn't be you. It would just be me. Like, that's why I was asking you, do you want me to finish this drawing? Or is this just, a thing, you want me to just kind of, rough and draw this piece exactly how you did it? And that's a big thing. If I wind up doing, you know, basic studies or using my books of gestures of other people, I'll wind up making something that you don't want. And, Yes, they do, sir. Let me show you. Crap. Where's my one book? Oh. There it is. Oh, here it is. I did have it. That's just some of them. I got this one that features the Don Tucci in a demonstration. See, you got Cher right here. Great fucking book. And then, of course, gotta have this one for Classic and Eye on Me. And I was a sucker in comic book crash coursing. When I went to college, I was trying to study animation. One of the professors there was Jerry Bryce, who was one of the animators for Cool World. He also worked for King of the Hill, did season 1 and 2 of He-Man. Fun military one, you know, it's kind of crappy. That one obviously has new models in it. Bought it at a Barnes and Noble. There we go. But the problem with that book is, of course, you don't have any muscular models or in shape. Christopher Hart books. This one's interesting because it actually has an interview with Brian Polito. Yeah, see? I did too. I used to work in a strip club, so the girls did pole tricks and did dances, so I would study some of the pole tricks and dances until my school was like, "You're not allowed to do that." Like, why? You got nude people we can draw. What's the difference? Oh yeah, for a while I just kind of got burned out. I got stuck in the Photoshop shopping and making flyers for a strip club chain. And then after that went to shit because, the corporate shut down that corporate office division, regional management division. So, I went into carpentry, surely by accident, and I stuck with carpentry for a long time because California, San Diego, Hollywood, it's all weird, and especially before social networks started becoming bigger and bigger, and, you know, this world of opportunity that came into place. It was like, nobody's gonna hire me. What's the point? And then at the point, you know, nobody was interested in that much IPs. I mean, the last great IP we really had during that time was Lock and Key. I think. Nowadays, everybody's looking for their quote unquote bus pass to Hollywood. Oh shit. You did that? That's gotta be interesting. Was it one of those jobs that's based on how many buses you got done in a night, or was it, or in a morning, or was it hourly based? Oh man, I'm sorry. God bless her soul. Your dad's kind of right. My personal experience, people come up to you and expect you to draw for them for free. Hey man, I got this awesome tattoo design that I'm gonna pay my tattoo artist to spend an hour and a half drawing it on my back while you spend 12 hours working on this sick design that I just want you to give to me. Damn, dude. Make somebody a tattoo for free. Yeah. But it's nice when you can see a paycheck from something you make, opposed to just being there. I feel you. And at this point, what do we have anymore? What are we going to leave behind? Dude, I'm 35 and I just got a letter in the mail of a discount offer of my cremation service. And I sat there like, what the fuck? Oh shit. Like, what the fuck does this even fucking mean? Okay, interesting. I was just wondering if it was a time-based hustle. Yeah, I did, Yeah, I did carpentry. I was a roadie for the past 6 years, so I did. I worked for Jay-Z, Foo Fighters, Bad Mouse, Bad Rabbit, Bad Bunny, whatever his name is, Pepe Aguilera, TV productions like Ink Master. Latin Grammys. So we'd start at like 6-7 o'clock in the morning, and sometimes want to get out till 11 o'clock at night, and then be expected to come back at work again at 6-7 o'clock in the morning again. Do the same thing over again. Okay. Did I make a boo-boo? I'm looking at this. Am I looking at this correctly? Okay, this is, this right here. Oh, shit. I hope you can see it. Fuck me. Fuck me. Alright, I got this back right here, right, and then it curls like this, and then I'm trying not to make a fly. I'm trying to make a demon. Oh shit. Alright, so I got this bump of the back, and then here's the bicep. Does the bicep slightly go behind her back? Is that what I screwed up? Oh, right here. Deltoid. Okay.
Shit.
Stop it, you're gonna make me laugh. My lines aren't gonna be as straight as they were before. Fuck. Okay. Yeah. So, just for future reference, because kind of learning as you go. Now, is she it kind of looks like she's kind of and you're drawing your intentions is yes, I'm on a stream. All right, I'll be right back. Sorry, my wife is disruptive. Yes. Well, first of all, she needs to be repositioned and replaced because, looking at your original drawing, and one thing I discovered that I didn't do, looks like you have, is, she's leaning on both the demons, right? Like, she's kind of just like chilling. It looks like she's kind of got herself comfortably, her back on the one demon's arm, and whatever this call right here, she's kind of comfortably leaning, and then she's got her other arm on this demon's thigh and knee, right? Okay, the legs are coming your way. I mean, our way. The viewer's way. Is that you, Frankie?
Yeah.
Let the dogs in, please. Out and to her right.
Demon to sleep again.
Okay. Left shoulder forward, about 15. You talking about this demon's shoulder or this demon's shoulder? The girl, okay. Left shoulder. About 15 degrees. Back into the body here. Weight rest on the arms. Okay. Yeah. Did I turn it down? No. It's Trent Reznor's wife's band. Technically, it's still Trent Reznor's band. It's still Nine Inch Nails, but with his wife. Yeah. It's going to be a long time right now. Monetization. Plus, it's not like monetization works for people like us anyways. Shit. Well, Caesar's streaming. You won't hurt my fifis if you leave and go see him. Cool. Definitely. Okay, cool. I'll see you tomorrow, boss. That doesn't mean goodbye. It just means yes, sir. I'll see you tomorrow. Unless you're going to see Caesar stream, which I don't blame you. Don't blame me there either, bud. Don't blame me there either. Yeah. I can't watch the stream, obviously. Let's see what Caesar's got to say.
Cyberfrog 2 Wrecked Planet. This is the sequel to Cyberfrog Blood Honey. This is the book everybody's been waiting for. The sequel to Cyberfrog Blood Honey is the biggest crowdfunding. necessary. Here's the video. Hello, potential Indiegogo backers. This is Ethan Van Skyver, and let me tell you about Cyberfrog 2, Wrecked Planet. In this follow-up, Blood Money, Cyberfrog wakes up in the year 2015. The final world has been devastated by vicious alien wasps called Vespas. The remains of humanity has fled into the woods for survival. Disconnected from
Cyberfrog, fighting back to the works of all. Now is your chance to sign up and be notified by email when this campaign launches in March.
So sorry, had to rub one in the toilet and wipe it with the t-shirt.
Woo! What a dump I had to take.
and excruciate feces out of my butt. So hard. So hard.
I gotta do some adulting stuff. Looks like I can't have fun right now. Alright, I'll be right back. If you like what you see, like, subscribe, hit the bell for notifications. Thank you all for coming on. What the fuck?